popular policy every once in a while. And there's this guy from the CIA, and he's creeping around Laurel Canyon.
Frank Zappa och hans Mothers of Invention strömmar förbi Stockholm i förra veckan. De svenska popjournalisterna infann sig till presskonferens och fick höra sina egna analyser om de råa och radikala, extrema och svåra, vulgära och psykedeliska Mothers bekräftas, men framförallt dementeras av Frank Zappa själv. Han pratade om det amerikanska samhället, om vad han skulle göra om han blev president, om reklam, undergroundpressen, hippies och experimentell musik. Frank Zappa.
There's a slang term in the United States called motherfucker, and mothers was short for motherfuckers.
That it was my school. Wah, 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 wah. I was the king of every school activity. But that's no more, oh mama, what will come of me?
My task, as you put it, is not specifically to criticize the American way of life. It just so happens that I live there. What I criticize is methods of social conduct which I find are either not quite sane or not realistic or are bordering on insane, I think. People are, in most places, are not very good mentally. They have a lot of problems. I think the biggest example of bad mental health in the United States is Governor Wallace. Wallace is by far the most dangerous. The other two are merely incompetent. Nixon is more dangerous than Humphrey, but they are both like losers. You know what that means? And there's no choice.
What's going to happen?
Well, we were looking at a paper today, and it said that Wallace has now 24% of the popularity. And that's frightening, that almost a quarter of the people in the United States would actually vote for that guy. That's sick. That guy's really crazy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
First thing I would do would be to legalize the use of drugs, legalize prostitution, legalize gambling. I would legalize all the things that people have been trying to legislate against for years, because it's a foolish thing to assume that a government, because it writes something on a piece of paper, that people will just follow along with that if it is against their nature. I think that there's a lot of sanity built into the Ten Commandments.
Beautiful. God, it's God. I say God.
I'm not specifically Christian. I don't go to church and I don't go through all that stuff, but I looked at that list of rules one time and I said, you know, that kind of makes sense. It's not bad. The main thing that we can do with our advertising that most other United States advertising people can't do is tell the truth, you see. Now, if we sell a product successfully by telling the truth about it, and you know how people imitate each other within an industry, you know? Let's say competitive advertising agencies see that we have sold so many units of a product by telling the truth about it. And I think, do we have to tell the truth about this refrigerator in order to sell it? You know, not. If they would compete on that level, then we would have really accomplished something. You see? And we're working towards that. I think that the advertisers have to realize that the people that they are selling products to aren't stupid, but they treat them as if they are. And because of that, advertising is an immoral business.
Think I'll just drop out. I'll go to Frisco, buy a wig, and sleep on Alfie's floor. Walk past the wig store. Dance at the Fillmore. I'm completely stoned. I'm hippie and I'm trippy. I'm a gypsy on my own. Stay a week and get the crab and take a bus back home. I'm really just a pony, but forgive me, cause I'm stoned. Every town must have a place where pony hippies meet. Psychedelic dungeons popping up on every street.
The story on underground newspapers. Do you realize that today there would be no underground newspapers in the United States if it weren't for the record companies? Do you know that underground newspapers stay alive simply because record companies have learned that they can sell product by placing full-page ads in an underground newspaper? They can sell more albums by doing that than through other media. See, that is their best printed media for record sales. And it's interesting that these underground newspapers, which are supposedly anti-establishment, are being financed by a very establishment organization. And I'm proud to say that we helped start that trend. People that we talk about in those songs are people who really never wanted to protest anything. What they wanted to do was leave their homes their middle class, fairly comfortable American homes and change their clothes and go out into the street and have a vacation. They weren't politically engaged or concerned. They were out there for a good time, and they put the beads on, they grew their hair out, you know. If there were enough experimental music to go around, I think because a person takes an amplifier and turns it all the way up and puts a guitar in front of it so that it squeals, it's not necessarily making experimental music. And radio stations, in order to sound experimental, might play a lot of this kind of music because there's more of that than there is good things. There are very few groups who are doing original, really new music in the United States. You know, people who put groups together are doing it for a number of reasons which generally don't include pure musical research. You know, the music is generally of secondary importance to their image or mystique.